The navigational bridge, also known as a pilot house or wheelhouse, is a room or traditionally a platform of a ship from which the ship can be commanded when a ship is underway. Clive Palmer's replica Titanic, called Titanic II, will surprisingly have a very state-of-the-art bridge. In fact, it looks a little like Captain Kirk's bridge on board the Starship Enterprise. It is worlds apart from RMS Titanic's original one, with all of its brass and wood. Titanic II will, of course, have modern propulsion, communications, and navigational systems, which will all be controlled from the high-tech bridge. You can clearly see the modern equipment, such as radar monitors. The radar equipment will be housed out of view, hidden within Titanic II's two front dummy funnels. This is to preserve the illusion of a 1912 ocean liner. The maneuverable electric engines, called azipods, will of course be directly controlled from the bridge, not from the engine room. A telegraph system is no longer required. The actual engines which generate electricity for the pods and all hotel systems will use marine diesel fuel rather than the traditional coal boilers. They are cleaner, more efficient, and more compact. All Titanic II's communications will also be carried out from the bridge. She does not need a separate radio room as the RMS Titanic had. Morse code will no longer be required. However, the Titanic II will have a recreation of the Marconi radio room for the passengers to see. Interestingly, Titanic will have a higher bridge than the original Titanic. The superstructure has been raised by 1.3 meters. This will give the captain and officers a better view over the bow of the ship. This also does away with the requirement on board the original RMS Titanic for lookouts in a crow's nest. The bridge will have open-air bridge wings, just like the original ship had. Modern ships fully enclose these now. This is the last known photo of Titanic's Captain Smith looking over from his bridge wing. If you look through the windows at the front of the modern bridge, there is a faithful recreation of the Titanic's original bridge. It will not have any function, but will be open for passengers to visit. This recreation is a very nice idea, but surely its location in front of the working bridge is impractical and probably violates marine safety regulations. Surely passengers would obscure the captain and crew's view. They would also make noise and use camera flashes. The captain and the crew need to clearly see out of the windows when underway to look at the sea in front of the vessel. Although there are now many modern navigational aids, such as radar displays, it is still important for the officers to make regular visual inspections using binoculars. However, maybe the plan is that the recreation of the bridge will only be open in port at anchor. It will be interesting to see if this idea is refined for the ship's final design.